This tutorial shows you how to calculate the minimum required sample size for the chi-square test of independence with G-power. A general introduction to G-power is linked in the info cards and also the video description. When we start G-power, we get this overview by default. We now need to select the chi-square test of independence first. This can be done via chi-square tests within test family and goodness of fit tests, contingency tables within statistical tests. Now you have to select the type of power analysis. Since you have to calculate the minimum required sample size in advance, you have to select a priori. The first input parameter needed is the effect size Cohen's omega, sometimes because of its similar shape also referred to as Cohen's W. The conventions for the behavioral sciences 0.1, 0.3 and 0.5 for small, medium and large effect sizes are shown as a tooltip and are taken from Cohen 92, a power primer. If you have research field specific thresholds, please use those instead. However, if you have a preliminary study or comparative study where a Cohen's omega or W already exists, then you should rather use that. The second input parameter is the alpha error probability, which is the probability of committing a type 1 error. This is the probability of wrongly rejecting the null hypothesis. 5% is the typical convention. 1% is a bit more restrictive. A value above 5% should be avoided though. The third input parameter is power. Power equals 1 minus the beta error probability. Beta error is the type 2 error. In short, this means falsely retaining the null hypothesis. 95% power is typical, meaning you have a 5% type 2 error probability. In some research fields, 0.8 is used here. This means you automatically accept a type 2 error of up to 20%. If you have power lower than 0.95, this calls for a reasonable justification. The fourth and final input parameter for the chi-square test of independence are the degrees of freedom. You have to calculate them in advance by multiplying the number of rows minus 1 and the number of columns minus 1 of your contingency table. Example, you want to test the possession of a driver's license, yes or no, with the place of living, urban, suburban and rural county. You multiply 2 minus 1 with 3 minus 1 and get 1 times 2, meaning you have 2 degrees of freedom. Finally, hit calculate to see the minimum number of observations needed to detect the presumed statistical effect with the predefined type 1 error probability and power. As a rule of thumb, a smaller effect size and a larger power require more observations than the other way around.